Welcome to the part 5. In this part, we'll start to make a sentence in English. Okay, table is here, everything is ready. But before we start, there is a task you have to do. You have to do a task before we start to make sentences in English. And your task is this. Make up 12 different sentences about doing karate in your native language. Please, do this in your native language. Write down 12 different sentences about doing karate in your mother tongue. For example, how do you say I did karate in the past tense in your native language? How do you say this in your mother tongue? I did karate. Write it down the way you express it in your L1. Or how do you say in the present simple? If you want to say something about doing karate in present simple, how do you say this in your mother tongue? Or in the present perfect continuous, in the past perfect, write something about doing karate. You should help me about this. You should help me in this matter because I don't know your mother tongue. I don't know your native language. If I knew your mother tongue, I would write down 12 different sentences about doing karate, and then I would show you how you are going to make English sentences. Okay, I hope you do this. I hope you write down 12 different sentences. So, if you have written all 12 different sentences, your next task is to detect the tenses of these sentences. Find the tenses of these sentences by using the table here. In the previous part, I showed you how to detect the tenses of the sentences. It's really easy. If you want, let's review them again. There were 3 questions, right? 3 questions you have to ask yourself. What were they? What is the time of the sentence, right? So that was the first question that you have to ask yourself. You have to determine the time of your sentences. Is it present or is it past or is it future? Which one? What is the time of the sentence? That's the first question. That was the first question. And the second one is there a perfect in the sentence, right? Is there perfect in the sentence? I told you to study the characteristics of perfect. And the last question was, is there continuity, right? Is there continuity in the sentence? That's all. If you can answer these 3 questions properly, you will be able to detect the exact tense of your sentence. You can detect the exact tense of your sentence with the help of these 3 questions. Briefly, you make a sentence in your native language and you ask these 3 questions and you will be able to find the tense of your sentence. That's easy. I hope you did this task. I hope you have written 12 sentences, found their tenses, and written them in this order. Because now we are going to start making sentences in English. Okay. Now, we have the 12 tenses and the 12 sentences. 12 sentences in your native language. And you found their tenses by asking 3 questions. L1 here means your native language. Imagine 12 different sentences in your native language about doing karate. You have written them. Imagine you have written these 12 sentences here. And now you have to make these sentences in these tenses. Now, you wrote something in the past in your native language and you detect that you should make this sentence in the past simple, right? You have to make this sentence in the past simple. So how do you do this? Remember the formulas in the table. What was the formula of the past? What was the formula of the past? It is verb 2, right? Verb 2. So that means we are going to make this sentence based on the past form of the verb do karate. The past form of the verb do karate is did karate, right? Do karate, the past form. Did karate. So we got the main verb here, did karate. When you put the subject at the beginning of the sentence, you almost complete the sentence. I did karate. All you have to do is just focus on the verb of your sentence. Focus on the verb of your sentences, because this way you can write your sentence correctly with the correct tense. The tense of this sentence is past simple. The formula of the past is verb to, and we change the verb of this sentence into past form. Do karate, did karate. And we put the subject at the beginning of the sentence. I did karate, and we complete. Okay, have a look at the present simple. You write something in here and you realize that you have to make this sentence in present simple. So, what is the formula of present? Remember the formula of the present? It is verb 1, right? Verb 1. Do karate. The first form of do is do, and the second one is did. The third one is done. And you have to memorize the irregular verbs. If you don't know them, please just memorize them. You're going to need them, because they play crucial role in these perfect tenses. You have to know them. You have to memorize them. And the sentence will be, I do karate. Okay. Present perfect continuous. Imagine you write something in here and you realize that you have to make this sentence in present perfect continuous, but you don't know this tense. You don't have to study the grammar books to learn this tense. All you have to do is just write down the formulas according to the name of this tense. What is the formula of present, for example? What is the formula of present? It is verb 1, right? Just write down the formulas of each of these according to the name. Present, it is verb 1. Perfect is have verb 3. Continuous, it be verb ing, right? I just wrote them in the order of this name. Present, perfect, and continuous. And now you have to make some kind of multiplication. I showed you in the previous parts. You have to make this multiplication. If you want to make the translation of your sentence, you have to do this multiplication. So the first form of have is have, and the third form of be is been. The main formula of this tense is have been verb ing or has been verb ing. I mean, have has been verbing verb. What is the verb? Do karate, right? Do karate, doing karate. Have has been doing karate. And what is the subject of the sentence? I, right? I have been doing karate. I just put the subject of the sentence and I complete it. I've been doing karate since my childhood or something. You can complete the rest of the sentence, but it's not important. Well, what is important is here. This part of the sentence is very important. Have been doing. Okay, let's have a look at the past perfect. Past, what is the formula of past? It is verb 2. The perfect formula is have verb 3. And we're gonna do the multiplication. The second form of have is had. Had verb 3. Had verb 3. What is the verb of the sentence? It is do karate, right? Do karate. The third form of do is done. I have done karate. I had done. It should be had, right? The second form of have is had. I had done karate. You can make the rest of the sentence as your wish. It's not important. What is important is here. I had done. Had done part is very important. Okay, past perfect continuous. Past perfect continuous. What is the past form? Formula of past is verb 2, right? And perfect and continuous. I just look at the name of the tense, and according to the order of the name or names, I just wrote down the formulas. Past, verb 2, perfect, have verb 3, continuous, be verb ing. And the multiplication, have, the second form of have is had, and third form of be is been. Had been verb ing, had been verbing. And what is the verb of the sentence? It is do karate, right? Do karate, doing karate. It should take ing, right? Doing karate, had been doing karate. And I just put the subject of the sentence. It is I, right? I had been doing karate. She had been doing karate, or they had been doing karate. So you can change the subject according to your sentence. All right, future continuous. Future continuous. Future, it is will verb infinitive, continuous be verb ing. Will verb infinitive be verb ing. So you should do this multiplication in this way, right? The end of this parentheses and the beginning of this parenthesis. The infinitive form of be is just be. Will be verbing. Will be verb ing. And the verb of the sentence is doing karate. Will be doing karate. I will be doing karate. I will be studying English. I will be sleeping. I will be going to somewhere. So you can change your sentence. All right. So past continuous. You write something in here and you realize that you have to make this sentence in the past continuous. You don't have to study this verb tense. All you have to do is just make a connection with English grammar and your own native language's grammar. Just write down the formula of past and continuous, verb to and be verb ing. The second form of be. What is the second form of am is are? It is was were, right? Was were verbing. Was were verb ing. Was were doing karate. I was doing karate. I was doing karate. Okay. Present perfect. Present perfect. What is the formula of present? It is verb 1 and perfect have verb 3. And multiplication. The first form of have is have or has, right? It is going to change according to the subject of your sentence, right? If it is he or she or it, you're going to use has verb 3. But I, you, we, they, you're going to use have verb 3. In this sentence, the subject is I. I have done karate. I have done karate. Present perfect. Okay. Future simple. What about future simple? Will verb infinitive, right? The formula of future, remember from the table, it is will verb infinitive. Will and the infinitive form of your verb in your sentence. Will verb infinitive. I will do karate. I will do karate. Okay. Future perfect continuous, future will verb infinitive, perfect have verb 3, continuous be verb ing, and the multiplication will have, the third form of be is been, will have been verbing, will have been doing karate, I will have been doing karate. And it is better to remind you, these tenses are not easy, they're very difficult, you know this, right? But in this system, you don't have to study them. You don't have to study the boring grammar books and grammar drills. All you have to do is just write down something in your mother tongue and ask 3 questions. And those questions are going to give you the tense of your sentence. And all you have to do is just put the formulas according to the name of this tense. Follow the order of the name. Feature, perfect, and continuous, and do this multiplication, and you're going to get your sentence in English. With the proof, you have the mathematical proof here. All you have to do is just make some effort to understand the system. Try to understand the logic of this system. How does it work? How does this system work? And if you can understand, if you can comprehend idea of the system, you will be able to use both of these tenses. Not just active tenses, you will be able to use passive tenses as well. Okay, present continuous, the formula of present and the continuous. You don't have to write verb 1 here. You don't have to write all the time because nothing will change. Let's imagine we write here verb 1 and the first form of be is just be. There was no change, that's why I didn't write here. Be, M is our verb ing, M is our, am doing karate. I am doing karate. He is doing karate. She is doing karate. They are doing karate. Okay. Future perfect and the last one. Future will verb infinitive perfect have verb 3. Will have done karate. The third form of do is done. Will have done karate. I will have done karate. Your duty in this part is try to understand the logic behind this multiplication system. Try to make sentence in your own language and try to find their tenses and use this multiplication process. In the future, you're not going to multiply all the time. You're not going to ask yourself those 3 questions to identify the tense of your sentence. You're not going to do them. You will be making English sentences automatically, instantly. But for now, you have to practice. Practice more. In the future, you're not going to use this multiplication process. Okay, I'll see you in the next lesson.